You know what you're listening to? You're listening to the Deen Team, bringing the light of Islam right into your hearts.
Follow us on Facebook at the Deen Team Sydney radio program and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Deen Team Sydney.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Welcome to the program, our dear listeners, and thank you for tuning in. You're here with the Deen Team, and with you today, your brother in Islam, Malaz Majani. And today we want to talk about the most important day of the week. You see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created time. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala divided time into years, months, days, according to His wisdom subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He says in the Qur'an, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن عدة الشهور عند الله 12 شهرا في كتاب الله يوم خلق السماوات والأرض يوم خلق السماوات والأرض منها أربعة حرم. That indeed the number of months with Allah is 12 lunar months. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the day He created the heavens and the earth, He made four of these sacred. Al-Ashhur al-Hurum. And subhanAllah, similarly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the week, and He made 7 days in the week. And He distinguished, the same way He distinguished 4 months from the 12 months, He distinguished one day from the 7 days. And the best and the most distinguished day of the week is Yawmul Jumu'ah. And this distinction has been there from the time He subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu qal, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خير يوم طلعت عليه شمس يوم الجمعة فيه خلق آدم وفيه أدخل الجنة وفيه أخرج منها وفي رواية فيه ستقوم الساعة. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the best day on which the sun has risen is Friday, and that was the day that Adam was created, and it was the day that he was admitted into Jannah alayhi salam, and it was the day he was expelled therefrom. As for the Jews and the Christians, you see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala diverted them away from this day. The Jews have their Saturday as their holy day, and Christians, of course, have the Sunday as their holy day. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this beautiful day to the Muslims. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala, to honor this day, He even gave a whole surah titled Surah Al-Jumu'ah, a whole chapter in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this surah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمُعَةِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَرُوا الْبَيْعِ ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. O you have believed, when the Adhan is called for the prayer on the day of Jumu'ah, proceed to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and leave your trade. That is better for you, only if you knew. SubhanAllah, you find that the Adhan is called 5 times every single day. And every single one of these prayers, these 5 prayers, are compulsory on every single day of the week. However, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala distinguished this Friday, and distinguished this Friday prayer. He subhanahu wa ta'ala made the distinction Himself. In fact, for the believer, the day of Friday is a day of Eid. It's a weekly Eid. However, you find, unfortunately, today, there are a number of reasons that keep people away from Jumu'ah prayer, such as work, or trade, or business, or occupations, or, you know, meetings. But from the time the Mu'adhin calls the second Adhan until the Imam finishes the sermon, then no trade, no business, no sales must be made at this time, because any trade or business or money earned in this time is not halal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَاةُ فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَابْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. He says, when the prayer has been concluded and finished, then disperse within the land and seek from the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and remember Allah often, that you may succeed. SubhanAllah, when the salah is finished, then you can go back to your work. And subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala permitted the Muslims to work on Friday, unlike the Jews and the Christians who have their Saturdays and Sundays off. One day, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was giving a Friday sermon, and a qafila, a caravan, came carrying merchandise. So the sahaba, because they didn't know any better, they stood up and left to do the trade. And they left Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam giving the khutbah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as correction for them. And as a lesson for us, he revealed the last ayah of Surah Al-Jum'ah. He says, وَإِذَا رَأَوْ تِجَارَةً أَوْ لَهْوًا فَضُّوا إِلَيْهَا وَتَرَكُوكَ قَائِمًا قُلْ مَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ مِنَ اللَّهْوِ وَمِنَ التِّجَارَةِ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ. But when they saw a transaction or a diversion, O Muhammad, they rushed to it and they left you standing. Say, what is with Allah is better than diversions and than a transaction, and Allah is the best of providers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that's the sustainer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that sustains and He provides for us. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us the benefit and the reward for attending Friday prayer. He said, قال رسولullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, من توضأ فأحسن الوضوء ثم أتى الجمعة فاستمع وأنصت غفر له ما بينه وبين الجمعة وزيادة ثلاثة أيام ومن مس الحصى فقد لغى. Abu Huraira, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him, he reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if anyone performs wudu properly, then he comes to the Friday prayer, listens to the khutbah attentively and keeps silent, his minor sins before that Friday, between that Friday and the following Friday will be forgiven with the addition of 3 more days. But he who touches the pebbles has caused an interruption. And this is a narration of Muslim. SubhanAllah, we must listen to the khutbah attentively and keep silent. You find some people today, when they see a certain khatib, they immediately discount the khatib and say, this is going to be a boring speech, so they fall asleep. Or, I don't understand the language he's speaking, so he falls asleep, or lacks concentration. Or similarly, how Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us not to touch the pebbles, you find that people today, they play with their phones, they're responding to emails, they check in their social media, Facebook, Twitter, subhanAllah. No, we should not do this. We must be attentive, even if we do not understand the language that the khatib is speaking, because this is the order of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, As-salawatul khamsi wal-jum'atu ila al-jum'ah, wa ramadanu ila ramadan, mukaffiratu ma baynahunna ila ishtunibatil kabair. Abu Huraira, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him, he said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the 5 daily prayers, the 5 daily prescribed salawat, and the Friday prayer to the next Friday prayer, and the fasting of Ramadan to the next Ramadan, is an expiation of the sins committed in between them. So as long as the major sins are avoided, subhanallah. And Rasulullah sallallahu, there's so much reward for attending. So much sins can be forgiven just by being attentive and following the sunnah of the day of Friday. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us the sunnah, one of the sunnah of attending this day. He said, إِذَا جَاءَ أَحَدُكُمُ الْجُمْعَةَ فَلْيَغْتَسِلْ. And this was reported or narrated by Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu. He said that the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when one of you intends to come for Friday prayer, then he should take a bath. SubhanAllah, some scholars have gone to say that this is a wajib to do the ghusl on the day of Jum'ah. Others have said that it is mustahab. Whichever opinion it is, well, this is the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it is something that we need to bring into our life. This is one way that we can prepare for Jum'ah. In addition, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, لا يغتسل رجل يوم الجمعة ويتطهر ما استطاع من طهر ويدهن من دهنه أو يمس من طيب بيته ثم يخرج فلا يفرق بين اثنين ثم يصلي ما كتب له ثم ينصت إذا تكلم الإمام إلا غفر له ما بينه وبين الجمعة الأخرى. And this is a narration of Bukhari where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if a man takes bath on a Friday and purifies himself as much as he can with wudu, oils his hair, fixes up his appearance, applies whatever perfume is available in his house, sets forth for the mosques, does not separate people to make a seat for himself, performs salat, which is prescribed for him, and he remains silent when the imam speaks, his minor sins between that Friday and the following Friday will be forgiven. SubhanAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is promising us forgiveness of all the weekly sins just by following the simple sunan of the day of Friday. And عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من اغتسل يوم الجمعة غسل الجنابة ثم راح في الساعة الأولى فكأنما قرب بدنه. Abu Huraira narrates that the one who takes a bath on Friday, likes a bath of purity, the ceremony of purity as we know, and then this person goes to the mosque in the first hour, it is like the one who offers a camel as sacrifice to seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ومن راح في الساعة الثانية فكأنما قرب بقرة. And the one who goes in the second hour is like the one who offers a cow to win the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ رَاحَ فِي السَّاعَةِ الثَّالِثَةِ فَكَأَنَّمَا قَرَّبَ كَبْشًا أَقْرًا. And the one who goes in the third hour is like the one who offers a ram with horns in sacrifice to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ رَاحَ فِي السَّاعَةِ الرَّابِعَةِ فَكَأَنَّمَا قَرَّبَ دَجَاجًا. And the one who goes in the fifth hour is like the one, or in the fourth hour, the one who goes in the fourth hour is like the one who has offered a hen for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ رَاحَ فِي السَّاعَةِ الْخَامِسَةِ فَكَأَنَّمَا قَرَّبَ بَيْضَهُ. And the one who goes in the fifth hour, or the last one that attends, is like the one who sacrifices an egg for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِذَا خَرَجَ الْإِمَامِ حَضَرَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الذِّكْرِ. And when the Imam ascends the pulpit, the angels who write the names of those who come to the mosque before the Imam coming in, close their record books in order to listen to the khutbah. SubhanAllah. This hadith, narrated in both Bukhari and Muslim, here Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam is encouraging us and advising us to go early to the Friday prayer. And the hours that are referred to are not certainly the 60-minute hours that we know of today, but they're more to do with the order. Whoever comes first to the mosque as early as possible is like the one who sacrificed a camel. Allahu Akbar, imagine sacrificing a camel for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then a cow, and then a ram, and then a hen, and then subhanAllah, the one who comes last is as if he has sacrificed an egg. SubhanAllah, imagine, look at the difference between sacrificing a camel and sacrificing an egg for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the other thing that we must look at as part of this hadith is where it says that once the Imam ascends the pulpit, the angels that write the names of the people entering and the order that they come in, they close their record books, they close the books, they stop writing, so they can listen to the khutbah. SubhanAllah. So we must all make an effort to be there as early as possible. Early as possible. SubhanAllah, you find unfortunately today that some people find out the time of when the salat takes place and they just want to come for the salat of Jumu'ah. It doesn't matter if they sit for the khutbah, sit for 5 minutes of the khutbah. If they miss the khutbah completely, they just want to pray the two raka'at. No, the khutbah, the sermon of Friday prayer is as important as the salah. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changed it. During dhuhr prayer, you pray 4 raka'at. But on the day of Jumu'ah, you listen to the sermon, which compensates for 2 raka'at, and then you pray only 2 raka'at, salatul Jumu'ah or salatul dhuhr. SubhanAllah, so this is an intention that all of us must make, that we go as early as possible to the day of Friday to attend the sermon. وعن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ذكر يوم الجمعة فقال فيه ساعة لا يوافقها عبد مسلم وهو قائم يصلي يسأل الله شيئا إلا أعطاه إياه وأشار بيده يقللها. What a beautiful hadith. Abu Huraira رضي الله عنه reported that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, while he was talking about the merits of Friday, he said there is a time on Friday at which a Muslim, while he or she is performing salat and is supplicating, will be granted whatever he or she is supplicating for. And he, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, pointed with his hand to indicate that this period is very, very short. So the day of Friday, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, is a day where we must supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a time to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this Friday. And in Islam, you need to realize that Friday starts from Maghrib Thursday, and it goes all the way through until Maghrib Friday. So you can start making dua after Maghrib on Thursday. And subhanAllah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ مِنْ أَفْضَلِ أَيَّامِكُمْ يَوْمُ الْجُمْعَةِ فَأَكْثِرُوا عَلَيَّ مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ فِيهِ فَإِنَّ صَلَاتَكُمْ مَعْرُوضَةٌ عَلَيْهِ. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, one of the other sunnah that we must practice on the day of Friday is, among the best of your days is Friday. On that day, pray to Allah to exalt my mention frequently, for your such supplications are presented to me. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stresses this in the Quran. He says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala confers blessing upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his angels ask him to do so, subhanahu wa ta'ala. O you who have believed, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to confer blessings upon him, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant him peace sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is an opportunity to make salah ala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We must remind our families, remind our relatives, our friends, and all the Muslims around us. It's because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the one that brought us this religion. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sacrificed so much for us. He even told us how to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on Fridays. So this is the reason why we need to make salutations and praise Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also told us, من ترك ثلاثة جمع تهاون من غير عذر من غير عذر طبع الله تبارك وتعالى على قلبه. That the one who doesn't pray three jumu'ah because he doesn't feel that it's maybe important or because he's neglectful, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will stamp his heart. And this stamping means that his heart will be sealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which means that iman will leave his heart. And in another narration, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, من ترك ثلاثة جمعات من غير عذر كتب من المنافقين والعياذ بالله. That whosoever leaves Jumu'ah prayer three Fridays without a valid reason, he is to be counted with the hypocrites. SubhanAllah. So we must ask ourselves then the question, what is a valid excuse? So the scholars of our religion tell us that there are seven excuses for a Muslim not to attend the Friday prayer. The first one is that it's not compulsory for a woman to attend Jumu'ah. She can pray at home. And the second one, the young child is not required to go to Friday prayer. And the third is a sickness or an illness that prevents you from going to the mosque. And the fourth excuse that can be used is a person who is a traveler, ليس على المسافر جمعه. So whoever is traveling is not required to perform Jumu'ah prayer. The fifth excuse is when someone fears for their life or for their family, so they can't leave the home. So that's a valid excuse in our religion. And the sixth is extreme weather conditions, of course. And the seventh is a slave. However, this does not apply to any of us today. So we all have relatives, we all have friends, we all know people that miss Salatul Jumu'ah because they're neglectful, because they don't see it as something important, because they don't realize the importance of this Salah and importance of this day. So it's our duty to remind them, our duty to advise them, our duty to encourage and tell people about the importance of Yawm al-Jumu'ah and the importance of Salatul Jumu'ah. I mean, some of the sisters might be listening and say, but this doesn't apply to me. Friday prayer is for the men. How does this apply to me? But subhanAllah, as a Muslim woman, you are required to advise your child. You are required to advise your husband, your brother, your daughter, all the men around you. You are required to advise them and tell them about the importance of this day. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, خَيْرُ يَوْمٍ طَلَعَتْ عَلَيْهِ الشَّمْسُ وَيَوْمُ الْجُمْعَةِ. The best of days that the sun has risen upon is the day of Friday. So subhanAllah, you find that we wait for seasons of worship. We wait for Ramadan, from Ramadan to Ramadan we wait. And then when we are in Ramadan, we wait for the last 10 nights because we know that there are nights where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has, you know, saves people from hellfire. And even within the last 10 nights, we wait for Laylatul Qadr, the night of power. SubhanAllah, from year to year, we wait for Hajj to be an event where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removes and expiates all the sins. And subhanAllah, every single week, we have a special event in Yawm al-Jumu'ah. That's why we must wait for this, look forward to this day. And Jumu'ah just means a day of gathering in Arabic. And I mean, there's no day more virtuous than Friday during the week. And subhanAllah, you find that our pious predecessors, they used to wait for that day. And they used to prepare for it. SubhanAllah, they used to prepare for the day of Jumu'ah. Because they know of the benefit and they know of the blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives on that day. Unfortunately, you find Muslims today end up preparing for the weekend and planning for the weekend, and they are neglectful of the day of Friday. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, every Muslim should prepare for Jumu'ah from Thursday. You see, after Asr on Thursday, one should increasingly make istighfar. Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. And the person that shall obtain the most benefit of Jumu'ah is the one who awaits it and prepares for it from Thursday. And subhanAllah, the most distinguished of the week is the morning of Jumu'ah. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from his sunnah was, he used to lengthen Fajr prayer on Friday. And he also used to read Surah Al-Sajda in the first ruk'ah. And he used to read Surah Al-Insan in the second ruk'ah. And he also used to recite a surah that has Sajdat Al-Tilawah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us so many sunan of that day. So many things we can do to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, the Friday day is an opportunity for us to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not need our worship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not need me or you to go to the mosque on Friday, or for me and you to go to the mosque early on Friday, or for me and you to take a bath before we go to the mosque. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not need any of this. On the contrary, we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's an opportunity for us to reconnect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And another one of the sunan that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave us was to read Surah Al-Kahf on Friday. It's narrated by Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whosoever reads Surah Al-Kahf on the day of Jumu'ah, a light will shine for him from beneath his feet to the clouds of the sky, which will shine for him on the day of resurrection, and he will be forgiven his sins between the two Fridays. Subhanallah. So much reward. So much reward and forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and light on the day of resurrection, on the day that we will need it most, just by simply reading Surah Al-Kahf on the day of Friday. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us about certain sunan that we must practice and bring back into our life. Like, for example, general cleanliness. So he advised sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to take a bath. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam advised us to trim our nails and to have general cleanliness on that day, because it's a day of Eid. Subhanallah, you find when we have a wedding or we have an event or we have a function, we get dressed up in the best of our clothes. And you find people spend so much time in front of the mirror, so much time, you know, decorating themselves and making sure that they look spot on for that event or for that wedding or for their wedding day. Subhanallah. The day of Friday is the same, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. The Muslim, the believing Muslim, should prepare himself in the best of his clothes for that day and the best of appearance for that day, for Salatul Jumu'ah, because it's a day of Eid, as we previously mentioned. We must also invite others to come to Friday prayer. I mean, all of us know someone that neglectfully misses Salatul Jumu'ah. We all know someone, a brother, a neighbor, a friend, a colleague at work. It is our duty to remind him. Of course, with wisdom, we tell him about the virtues of Friday prayer, the virtues of Friday. And when we invite them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us a reward for that. And when you find someone, you bring your people back to the mosque, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you extra reward for this. So this is something that we encourage. We encourage people to talk about the importance of Friday prayer. And subhanallah, I mean, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِذَا كَانَ يَوْمُ الْجُمَعَةِ كَانَ عَلَى كُلِّ بَابٍ مِّنْ أَبْوَابِ الْمَسْجِدِ الْمَلَائِكَةِ يَكْتُبُونَ الْأَوَّلَ فَالْأَوَّلِ فَإِذَا جَلَسَ الْإِمَامِ طَوُوا الصُّحُفْ وَجَاءُوا يَسْتَمِعُونَ الذِّكْرِ. Subhanallah. We mentioned a similar hadith earlier on, where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, when the day of Friday is upon us, on the door of every mosque, the angels will stand with their books and they're writing who comes in first, followed by who, until the imam stands. When the imam stands, or the imam sits for his khutbah, begins his khutbah, they close the books and they come to listen to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ, race to all that is good. This is a beautiful opportunity, my brothers in Islam, to race to that what is good, to come early to Friday, to reap the rewards, to make sure that the angels write us down in the people that come early. And we have to make a plan. I mean, I need to ask myself, how does this apply to me? How does this apply to my life? What's my plan? How do I propagate this message to my family, to my friends, to my neighbors? Subhanallah, you find, unfortunately, in our day and time, you find that people, as they exit Jumu'ah prayer, they can't even remember what the khutbah was about. Subhanallah. And this shaitan is the most deceptive of people. The moment that you leave the mosque on Friday, he comes in the form of your best advisor. And he tells you, mashallah, that was a very nice khutbah, very nice talk, that was a good reminder. However, you've got more important things in your life. The shaitan wants to give you advice. He wants to tell you and give you long hopes that, yeah, you got time. You got long, long, long time. You got a long time ahead of you. Don't worry about what the imam said now. Don't worry about the khatib said now. No, you're busier at work now. You're busier with your studies. You're busier with this. You're busier with that. And the shaitan uses his normal trick of deception. وَمَا يَعِدُهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا, that this shaitan, اللعين, الشيطان الرجيم, does not give you promises except false ones. He gives you false promises, gives you these long hopes, and that's what he does at the end of every khutbah. So we need to be mindful. We need to take, when we listen to a khutbah, we say, what action points can I take into my life? What can I start practicing from the words of advice that I heard from the khatib or from the imam? Each and every single person is a different level. So each and every single person listening to the khutbah of Jumu'ah must take something from it. What's my three takeaway points from today's khutbah? Something that I can talk about to my family when I return home. Something that I can talk about to my children when I go back home. To my wife, to my spouse, to my neighbor. Whoever is around me, I tell them these are the 3 points that I learned, or the 1 point, or the 2 points that I learned from today's khutbah. And this is something that we highly encourage, so that we can bring back the understanding and importance of this deen into our lives. My dear brothers, Friday prayer and Yawm al-Jum'ah has so much significance in our religion. And we need to bring back the importance of Friday prayers in our lives. This is very, very important. also from the Sunnah of Rasulullah, we need to ensure that we are early, that we arrive early to the mosque, so that our names get registered early, so that we reap the maximum reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanAllah, we need to keep in mind and stay mindful that any trading during the time of Jum'ah, during the time of the khutbah, is haram. So we need to ensure that we are not doing any trading and that we free ourselves for that time. I mean, a lot of Muslims living out here in the West, they plan quite easily to take Friday lunchtime off so they can go and attend a Jum'ah khutbah. Alhamdulillah, the mosques are widespread all over the place, so there is no excuse for anyone missing the khutbah and missing the Friday prayer. No excuse whatsoever. Don't make any excuses for yourself. This is more important than your work. This is more important than what you're doing. This is more important than the trade or the small amount of dollars that you can be making. So we need to ensure that we are not trading during the time of Jum'ah. Another very, very important point is that we need to be silent and attentive when the khatib is speaking. Because you find, as we said and mentioned earlier, that a lot of people tend to get carried away with their phones, with their emails, with their social media. Or some people fall asleep, they take it as an opportunity to fall asleep, and they wake up when with iqamat al-salah, subhanAllah. But this is not the purpose of Friday prayer. The purpose of Friday prayer is for the Muslims together, the Muslims to come together and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I mean, what a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful system Islam is. Islam is giving you an opportunity every single week to come together with your brothers, come together as a society, come together as a community, and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is something that we need to keep in mind. Keep in mind frequently that I'm there for my benefit. I'm listening to the khutbah for my benefit. And we all need to deduce some key learnings that we can take away and use in our day-to-day life and practice in our life. And also, we also spoke about the importance of ghusl, the importance of perfume, the importance of wearing the best of clothes when we go to the Jum'ah. And we should also, we must make a lot of dua throughout that day, so that we hope and we have high hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we catch the hour where the dua is answered and the dua is not rejected. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us an opportunity to accept our dua. So we increase our dua on that day. We increase the dua. From the time Thursday Maghrib comes, I make a lot of dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hoping that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will, you know, I'll make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that moment where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts the dua. And I'll make plenty of salah ala Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam instructed us. And he is the best of teachers for us. And we also need to ensure that our families, our friends, the people that we know, don't miss Jum'ah. Don't miss Jum'ah. It's only about an hour and a half. Wallahi, sometimes you find people are so busy because of work, because of some sort of commitment, they leave and they neglect Salatul Jum'ah. This is no excuse. This is not an excuse at all, my dear brothers in Islam. We must make preparations. Make preparations to call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Call so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and just remind, وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remind, because verily the reminder benefits the believer. He did not say it benefits the disbeliever or the one that's an atheist. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says the reminder benefits the believer. So if I have a believing relative, I have a believing friend, a colleague at work, someone that I know is Muslim, but he is constantly missing Friday prayer after Friday prayer after Friday prayer, and I know that his heart is being stamped black, 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 it's my duty to remind him. Of course, with wisdom, we remind each other. And we must prepare ourselves. We prepare ourselves for Friday. We look forward to that momentous occasion where we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it's an opportunity for us, for our sins, for our weekly sins to be forgiven. So it's something to look forward to, something beautiful to look forward to, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us a beautiful opportunity, so we must make the most of it, make the most of it. And of course, it's very important, my dear brothers in Islam, that we reflect on the khutbah, reflect on what the Imam and the Khatib is saying, and give ourselves an action plan, something that I can use from today's khutbah to bring me closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bring me closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I encourage the wives and the mothers out there to ask their husbands and their sons and their siblings and their fathers, what was the khutbah about today? Make it a conversation. This is, I mean, when you talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the angels descend. Make the Friday khutbah topic a conversation amongst the family. When the man goes to the khutbah, he learns something new, he must come back and share this with his family. And the family must ask him, what did you learn today? What was the khutbah about today? What was one point that you want to bring into your life? And this is how we encourage khayr. We encouraged good in our lives. And this is something that is very important. We need to come back and return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what a better opportunity than the day of Friday to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We start by the same hadith. We started with a hadith where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, خَيْرُ يَوْمٍ طَلَعَتْ عَلَيْهِ الشَّمْسُ يَوْمُ الْجُمْعَةِ فِيهِ خُلِقَ آدَمْ وَفِيهِ أُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ وَفِيهِ أُخْرِجَ مِنْهَا. That the best day on which the sun has risen is Friday. On that day, Adam was created. He was admitted to Jannah on that day, and he was expelled from Jannah on that day as well. Friday, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, is a very momentous day in our religion. We must think differently about Friday. We must return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and see it as an opportunity to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what Yawm al-Jum'ah is all about. This is what Friday prayer is all about. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is our teacher, our instructor, our role model, he taught us about the importance of Friday prayer. So we should bring back the sunnah of Fridays into our lives. Find out what the sunnah of Friday are, and I want to bring them back into my life. And that's how a Muslim should be. A Muslim should always be proactive and look for the opportunities where he can return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what better opportunity than the Friday prayer? I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those that act upon what they hear. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Until next time, thank you for tuning in to the Deen Team. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Follow us on Facebook at the Deen Team Sydney radio program and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Deen Team Sydney.